good evening. Today, tonight, we have the pleasure to interview a very special guest, live from Tweedleslurp, Wet Dun County, a consummate and celebrated antipathist turned politician, Mr. John. How's your father, Snortbottom? Welcome.
Good evening.
Thank you for being with us tonight.
I think it's my pleasure, yeah.
It has been suggested, Mr. Snortbottom, that you are running for government. Is that correct?
Well, that's a definite possibility.
I see. Could you please define what you mean by a definite possibility?
Simply said, it's definite that I might run for the government, yeah.
Well then, let's get this correct for our viewers. You're saying definite possibility by means you mean possible, but surely you don't mean it's definite at all.
No. I'm saying that is a definite possibility because there's a possibility that it will be definite.
Mm-hmm. Right. Isn't that just contradicting yourself?
Quite possibly not at all.
Well, by saying that it's a definite and then followed by a possible, surely you're just creating an oxymoron.
No. Of course I may say definite possibility as being completely and certifiably possible. Look, if I just said it's definite, then there would be no question it would happen. But you see, in this case, I can't be sure it will happen. And by saying it's just possible would be too ambiguous and vague. So, by combining definite and possible, I'm letting you know that it's possibly definite.
Huh. But if you're saying it's a definite possibility, surely you're not saying it's either possible nor definite. I mean, that's just null and voiding both, because it just doesn't mean anything. I mean, how can you make something definite and possible at the same time?
How can what be definite and possible at the same time?
How can what we were talking about be definite and possible at the same time?
What were we talking about?
Right, I'm sorry to cut this interview short. We seem to have run out of time. That was Mr. John, how's your father, Snortbottom, on the subject of politics. Next week, we are talking to the great African Swahili opera diva, Dame Wahia, tickle your fat ass with a feather, on the subject of touring on a low-carb diet. Until then, good night.